You know, the best part about this year is that we have so many people that can kind of step in and lead this team. You know, losing a player of Clara's ability obviously is a tough hole to fill. But I, you know, like for instance, today was our very first day of practice, and I'm just blown away with the leadership that I saw in day one. You know, we had so many people step up and do so many things well. So, yeah, losing a player of Clara's ability is tough. It will always be tough to fill. But I see all 10 of my girls stepping up to a leadership position this year. So that, it, you know, from that standpoint, I'm thrilled because, you know, as a coach, you couldn't ask for anything better than that. Well, you know, the girls that are returning, they, you know, coming off the year that we had, it was a little bit tough for us because we had never experienced a year with so many injuries or, you know, just a really, well, to be honest, our first losing year ever. So the veterans or the returners, they knew that preparation was going to be crucial for this fall and this spring of 15. So they went home and really worked, and from what I understand, they communicated a lot with the then-coming girls. So everybody was under the same mindset, like, you know what, we don't want to repeat last year. We want to go back to the normal cycle that we always have had, which has been, you know, being a winning program here at Tulane. So they just stressed preparation, you know, and I think they heard it from me quite a bit. So I got to be honest, they came in today, they've come in last week and they started with their workouts and they've done so many things well. So preparation is not an issue for us. I mean, today was a pretty tough workout and they got through it just fine. So, you know, the preparation aspect has been fully handled. Usually, in most sports, you have the returners being outnumbering the new girls, which in this instance, we have pretty much as many or more new girls. So, you know, I think it's very easy for new girls to come in and feel nervous or to wonder what's to be expected. And, you know, that's with any sport. So just the new blood alone, the new dynamic, the way they look at things, the way they approach things. I think, you know, the new girls are going to learn from upperclassmen and the upperclassmen are going to learn from the new girls. So it's a win-win either way. And, you know, obviously all these girls can play really good tennis. And on top of that, they're great girls off the court. They're great students. So, you know, again, I can't complain with anything. I mean, like I said, today I was just blown away with what I saw. So it's a definite recipe for success this year. And, you know, for me, watching the girls today, you could tell they knew it as well. We had one of our upperclassmen, Epec Barol, step up and kind of give a speech before the team got started this morning, and it meant a lot to me to see her step up as a leader, one of many leaders, and kind of tell the girls, like, look, this is what we want to accomplish, this is what we're about, let's work hard. So the new blood with the returners, it's a win-win. You know, Vanessa is here a year early. She decided to graduate a year early from high school and come to us, so she is very young. And even in the recruiting process, watching her play, even as recently as a couple of weeks ago in San Diego, this young lady has such a tremendous upside in so many areas. I mean, she's 35th in the country, USDA, you know, comes in as a five-star recruit, and her ability is tremendous, you know, and not just on the tennis court, with her recruiting contacts. It's scary to me how over the summer she continues to reach out to me about certain players, like they're interested. You know, you bring that in with a great attitude, a great student, and a superb athlete. I mean, you know, you can never go wrong with the Vanessas of the world. So we're thrilled that she decided to come to school a year early and be a part of our program. You know, John and I have had about 2 or 3 weeks together now before school got started. So, you know, there's always a learning curve anytime you bring in a new coaching staff member. But John and I see eye to eye on so many things. It's kind of creepy, honestly. He's very funny, very outgoing, very sarcastic, all of which mimic me. So he and I get along really well off the court. And on the court, we've talked about each player and what we want to see for each player, and especially like recruiting contacts and those things. So he's a huge asset for us. You know, great attitude, great guy. The girls already seem to love him. And, you know, I'm excited to work with him. When you get a good guy who cares and is passionate about what he does, it's another win-win. Well, we've got 3 weeks to prepare for Notre Dame, and, you know, we know going into this tournament, this is a tough tournament, but like I said in previous interviews that, you know, I was never going to have a soft schedule. I just don't want to have that. I don't think it, you know, it develops our players the way we want them to. So we have 3 weeks to kind of really get in shape, find some doubles combinations, kind of see where, you know, we think the lineup's going to stack out. And, you know, right now, and any coach will tell you in the fall, it's all about seeing how the girls respond. How do they respond when something goes wrong? Or, you know, how well are we prepared physically? You know, because what you'll notice too is that some girls' bodies tend to break down a little bit because maybe they're not completely physically set for the fall. So we're going to go up there. We're going to have a great time, number one. We're going to learn a lot about each other. It's a completely new team, and we're going to go play hard. We're going to compete hard. We're going to learn, and we're going to prepare for the spring. Year seven for me is big in so many ways. Number one, number seven is my favorite number. So it's actually, I've thought about this. I'm like, oh, wow, year seven, my favorite number. This is going to be a great year. I can't believe I've been here 7 years. You know, I've got so many kids now that have come and gone, and it's shocking to me. And what I found, and I told somebody this summer, when Claire made it to the NCAA singles championship postseason for the first time since 2005, as a Tulane tennis player ever made it, I found myself standing there, and I fell in love with my job all over again. And I got excited about the fall, and I got excited knowing about what our future holds. And with all these girls coming in, I think they had the same level of excitement because they feel it for me as well. So year seven is going to be a great year. It's a turnaround year for us. And, you know, I definitely see a lot of great things happening for us.